Helping children discern fake news and misinformation online is so crucial in today's digital age. We're going to share some strategies parents can use to inform their children. The first, educate them about critical thinking. Encourage them not to trust the information that they are consuming. Teach children to question the information they encounter. Explain that not everything online is true, and it's important to think critically about the source and content. Teach them evaluation techniques. Yes, guide them on how to assess the credibility of a website or author. For example, checking the author's credentials, looking for citations. Yes. And considering whether the site is reputable. You should go further and discuss the sources. Explain different types of media. Help them understand the difference between reputable news outlets, blogs, and social media. Highlight that traditional news organizations usually have fact-checking processes. And then go ahead also and talk about bias. Explain how bias can influence the way news is reported and how different perspectives can lead to different interpretations of the same event. We will obviously advise you to use real examples, examples that they can identify with at their age. So you sit down and analyze news together. Pick up a piece of news or information together and dissect it. Discuss how to check facts, what sources to trust, and how to recognize signs of misinformation. Show them fact-checking websites like Snopes, factcheck.org, or PolitiFact. I think that's how it's pronounced. And show them how these resources can be used to verify information. Now, in addition to that, you have to promote safe online habits. Limit unsupervised access to the internet. For younger children, control access to online information by using parental controls or monitoring their internet usage. Encourage open dialogue. This seems to be the be-all and end-all of all our videos where we try to shade our kids. Communication is so key. But let there be open dialogue. Create an environment where children feel comfortable discussing what they see online with you. If they encounter something questionable, they should know that they can come to you for help. Teaching them about emotional manipulation cannot be overemphasized. Discuss the role of emotions. Explain how some fake news stories are designed to provoke strong emotions to make people share them without thinking. Teach them to recognize and resist these manipulative tactics. You must also encourage responsible sharing. Think before you post. Pause before sharing. Instill in them the habit of pausing to verify information before sharing it online. Encourage them to think about the potential consequences of spreading information. Now, crucially, our last point will be leading by example. As a parent, you have to model good behavior. Be a role model by practicing what you preach. Show them how you verify information, avoid sharing unverified content, and remain critical of the information you encounter. By combining education, practical tools, and open communication, we as parents can empower our children to navigate the online world more safely and responsibly. I've been your host. Until next week, God bless and goodbye.